tip. I'm so excited.
But let's keep it together. At least until the first death.
I hope your front door is locked and your phone is switched off. It's match time. And nothing can come in the way of a head coach and his blood bowl.
For tonight's match, I'm playing against Berg787. Hello, Berg.
Hello.
Hello. Welcome to the stream. Thank you for joining me. Right. Yeah, pretty good. Pretty good. The guests are out of the house, and Mrs. Sage is doing the dishes, as you can hear.
Yeah, I keep sadly hearing in the background.
Yeah, that's of course very much appreciated, or I would have been even later.
Yeah, all right. Well, fair enough. But she's doing us all a favor.
She's doing us all a favor, exactly. Very happy you could join us. Something came up during our previous matchmaking plans, and you sent me an email on the address that I rarely read, so you thought you'd reach me and everything. It's all good.
Bit of a mix-up there, but yeah. Sometimes personal life, unfortunately, comes... gets in the way of Blood Bowl.
It does this, yes. And vice versa, I have to say.
True. More so that than the other way around, yeah.
Yeah, so... as a brief introduction, I should probably point out Berg has a pretty successful YouTube channel where he plays, amongst other things, Blood Bowl 2 and XCOM, is that right?
Yeah, at the moment that's mainly what I've been doing up until, well, Civ 6 rather is going to be coming out at the end of the week, so a bit of that as well. But thanks for the free shout out.
Yeah, sure. Sure thing. So, and thank you for joining me here. Now, I don't actually see you on cam yet. Is that right?
Yeah, I'm cam issues.
Cam issues. All right. So we're going to do a voice chat and not a cam chat stream.
There we go.
Right. Okay. That's fine. Cool. Let's go to the match, shall we?
Ready then?
Yeah, let's have a look. So you've got... let's see, I'm playing Chaos, and I'm playing Orcs, against Orcs, and if I'm not mistaken, we're now 8 games old.
I think so, that's my stats. Yeah. 9 games old, actually.
Yeah, I remade after the first game, because it was kind of bad.
Oh yeah, I heard about this, you had a couple of, deaths, was it?
Well, I think it was 2 deaths and 1 MNG or something, but bad enough to be better off starting over.
Absolutely.
Yeah, my chat is saying cam issues means not able to find clothes. Yes.
Could be. I am fully clothed.
All right.
Believe it or not.
Yeah. So the funny thing is, usually when Chaos teams are 8 games old, they are not quite ready to face Orcs. But in this case, I've kind of prioritized in a way that I think Orcs are one of the better matchups for me now.
Oh, absolutely. When you've got 2 Claw Mighty Blow, which I'm terrified of. Yeah,
that was kind of a thing. I even took Claw before Mighty Blow on a guy. That's a first, but that's because I skilled him right before I played the previous Orc team. So I figured for that specific matchup, it was worth it. Normally, I'd never do that.
Did you used to have a +1 movement boost?
Yeah, I did, but something happened to it. Yeah,
that's
dreadful,
delicious.
Dreadful shame. Yeah, I actually rolled another and then decided to skip it. So now I've got 3 block, which feels so mature for a Chaos team.
Well, last time I checked your team, I think you maybe had 1 block, but like I'm not even sure if you had that last time I had a look. So
yeah, my last game I had 1 block, and the 2 others are just skilled up in the last game. So that's right.
To be honest, I was hoping to play you early.
I can see how you might. If my first 2 matches had been against Orcs, I would be pretty annoyed. Yeah. No, I'm ready to face Claw. Now my priorities have to be getting a sure hands and a tackle because the elves are coming.
I'm going to tell you now, you just got to make sure that those 2 Claw Mighty Blowers fall on the floor, because if they do, it's going to be a stamp or 2.
Okay, that sounds excellent. You have a dirty player, I see.
I do,
You also have a bench that helps a bit.
I was half tempted to actually get rid of my thrower for this game just to lower my TV a little bit, but then I thought, you know what, probably we'll lose a player or two, so it might not be a bad idea to have the bench.
Yeah, and you know, even if I don't kill them, having a spare to replace your dirty player isn't bad.
True.
Yeah, so I think I would have kept them too. I see a niggle. I like. Yes.
Oh, it's not a niggle, actually.
Minus movement. Yeah. I see. Whenever I see the stats not show a decrease and there's a red plus, then I assume it's a niggle. But in this case, he's got plus movement, minus movement.
Basically, the guy just doesn't want to... I wanted to sack him off, but he got injured in, like, the spin games.
Mm-hmm.
And but he already had Mighty Blow, and he was like my only Mighty Blow guy, and I was like, all right, well, I'm just going to keep him until I get more and then sack him off at some stage, but
and
got his movement.
Yeah.
I mean, I'll get rid of him eventually, but you know, he's sort of stuck around.
Yes, I said cross, right? I said cross, definitely. Everyone just heard me wrong. All right, let's do this.
All right, let's go.
Here we go. 1300 against 1410.
I've sent the invite, so...
Oh. Are you sure? I think I sent an invite as well.
So, all right. I'll cancel mine.
Oh.
Did
okay.
You cancel yours?
Why don't you invite me? That's right. A good idea. Yes. I'll sit here and wait.
Thank you, then.
It's not showing.
It's definitely sent. Okay, precisely.
Huh.
If the invitation expires at 1 minute, 15, 14, 13.
Did we brokercade it?
I mean, I can try again. If I cancel and then you send it to me, see if that works.
Yeah, let's try that.
Just give it like 20 seconds. Maybe the server's like a bit weird.
Click the flashing circle. What flashing circle?
Oh, right. Okay. Yeah, I see. It's next to the little settings thing underneath the start match. I was actually wondering why it was flashing, but it's fine. We're on now anyway. I swear that didn't happen before. I swear it was just like you could click on there, but I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. Right.
I have no money to buy any kind of inducement, so...
I have money to buy lots of things, actually.
I know.
Do I... I could do two babes. I could do a bribe.
I think you should save your money.
I could do a wizard. Wizards are nice.
Yeah. They're not bad. I've heard good things about them.
You've got two Mighty Blow, right? I can actually look at that.
Yeah, but I wouldn't lie to you, Sage. I wouldn't lie. It's two Mighty Blow.
Yeah, let's see. I'm going to go with two babes. You know, I've got plenty of armor 8. I think this is sensible enough.
I probably concur. Probably. Are you saving that? Are you saving that money in the bank for anything in particular? Or?
Well, for replacing players after this match.
I was going to say for a rainy day. Is that what it is?
Yeah, well, I like splurging when I have more money available. Mm-hmm. At the moment, I've still got 11 players. I quite like having 12. You know, this game, I might well lose two. So
12 is always a nice number. It just gives you that little bit of flexibility. Ooh, rain.
Yeah. Yeah, it's nice for fouling. It's nice for replacing hurt guys. It's all good.
Especially on more bash orientated teams, you don't want to be starting with less players.
I won the toss. Let me think about that. Well, actually, in this case, since it's raining, it wouldn't have been a terrible idea to hand you the ball.
But I was kind of hoping you would hand me the ball because I wanted to get my Mighty Blow in first. But,
yeah. In this kind of matchup, that's probably quite a serious idea. Yeah, so Squiggy is saying, please kill anyone who either has sure hands or tackle or is close to getting it.
How about don't kill anyone? That's always a good plan as well.
Yeah, I'm all in favor of that.
I tell you what, badly hurts. That's what we'll make a gentleman's agreement that only badly hurts. And I'll live
with it. Yeah, I'm just going to roll the dice and see what happens, but I like that. I like the sentiment anyway.
Damn you and you roll the dice and see what happens. What kind of fun is that? Deary me.
Murder everyone. This sounds splendid.
Well, that's kind of the plan, isn't it?
So, kill anyone with sure hands. That's your own thrower, right? That's
yeah.
That's
well, he's on the bench for now. So.
Well,
there you go.
It would be. It's kind of weird, really, that there's no way to for the bench players to get hurt.
Yeah, I mean, they can't even be hit by a rock or anything.
Like yeah, that. Exactly.
It's true. You would almost think that, you know, with how violent the crowds are, being in the bench, it would actually be maybe even more dangerous.
Yeah, you'd think so. Let's see. I'm just going to go and hit this then. And actually, we're going to blitz there. Would I prefer to blitz with him? Maybe. Then I can go here. And there.
I don't like all this talk of blitzing.
Blitzing? Yeah, no. Blitzing is
bad.
Blitzing is bad indeed.
It's amateur.
Blitzing
that's what
is terrible. I don't see why people would blitz.
No, especially when they've got horns. If anything, you probably don't want to do that ever.
Exactly. Terrible, terrible idea.
I really hope that you don't pick up the ball.
Yeah.
Since you chose that. Well, you know what will happen. It'll probably change weather. And
weather
nice.
Change, yeah. Yeah. Been there. Do I like this? I'm going to mix things up a little bit.
Looks all right to me.
Yeah, what I'm trying to figure out is safety versus effectiveness. Because Mighty Blow is not that great by itself. Yeah, whatever. It'll do.
When in doubt, just hit continue.
Yeah, that sounds splendid, doesn't it?
There we go. And to be fair, it was a nice kick as well. Like, where, you know, yeah. I wouldn't have minded it being there if it was raining as well.
Well, yeah. Yeah, I can see that. I can see that.
Because the problem is, if it had been raining, if you don't re-roll the pickup and it scatters.
And it bounces
towards,
through the. Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, that can be awful. Right, so. We're going to block there. That's good. Like that. Uh-huh. And then we're going to block 4, 5, 6. This could be a 3-die later. You can go here. I don't really need to follow that per se. Oh, hey, look. Wow, dirty player. That was
on a dig as well.
Yeah,
I'm half tempted to apo it just because I don't. Now, fucking, I've still got. sorry if I swear. I don't know if you swear.
Oh yeah, I heard on your channel that you sometimes like to use good words.
I do occasionally. Yeah, so I'll try and tone it down.
I just wanted to point out that this stream is marked for mature audiences only. So.
Then we're good. Then fuck
yeah,
shit.
Exactly.
Yeah,
exactly. Yeah, so we're good. Right, so this one would be very nice to hit a pow on. Yes, thank you. And it's the claw.
Okay, that's good. That's a victory for me. That is only stunned.
Yeah. Well, claw did make the difference here.
It didn't
and
mean.
We're gonna hide like a little girl. Wait! Oh crap! Oh shit! That was supposed to be a 3-die with help. But who cares? Because I don't need 3 dice. I can do this.
Oh wow!
Yeah, claw mighty blow against orcs is kind of helpful. Right. And you know, I don't have block, so I figured I'd hit the wrestle guy because. Block wouldn't help me kill him anyway.
I can't really afford to go more men down, so I had to apo him.
Yeah, at least it was a badly hurt, so the apo is effective,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And, you know, since I've done every player except for the guy picking up the ball, I guess, wow. That was a pretty splendid turn, I have to say.
I was going to say, as far as turns go, I was fairly impressed.
Yeah, yeah.
Not happy, but impressed.
Yes.
Okay.
Toenail claws. Yeah, that's right.
Who's got toenail claws?
Well, so my my warrior used claw to hit your guy, but he kicked him instead of hitting him, so he'd have to have toenail claws to make that work.
Ah, right. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, coming through his big boots, that would be a bit nasty.
Exactly. Yeah, I play a character in Dungeons & Dragons who sometimes changes into a were-tiger, or who is now a were-tiger, actually, and she can't wear boots because they break every time she shifts. It's,
really?
It's a real pain. Yeah, it actually says so in the prestige class description. If she changes, boots and gloves break. It's really annoying.
Can't knock, won't knock.
All right, he looks nice. He looks nice. I want to be friends with him.
Ah, oh, dearie me. Oh, well.
Yeah, I think this is the kind of matchup that can go very bad for orcs. I mean, all things considered, your one big factor that sets you apart from other teams?
Armor.
Yeah, that's about it. Everything else is just, you know, you've got crappy movement. You've got some strength, but, you know, not like lizards. The fact that everyone has armor 9, pretty much, is the redeeming feature they have.
Yeah, claw. Just horrible thing, really. Unless I've got it, that's great. You
know, yes.
Until I get it, it's rubbish. It's horrible. Should be banned, I think, personally.
Yeah, well, I'm more of an elf coach, mostly. Yeah. Oh, there we go.
Yes! Eat that!
Oh. Yeah, eat that reroll, and then kill a block mighty blow orc.
Yes!
What?
That's another victory.
Oh, yeah, that it is.
I'm viewing big victories. You'll be shocked at the end of the game when I proclaim myself the winner, regardless of the score. multiple moral victories.
Yes. This is a black orc, is it not? Yeah, so that's not really all that good. But I think I'm willing to go here anyway.
Basically, if I keep pounding on your beastmen, sooner or later, they've got to get hurt. That's the way I see it.
Yeah, that's why I have the Bloodweiser babes.
Wow, I tell you what, Sage, Bloodweiser babes won't help you when they're dead.
Unless
they've changed the rules, I don't know.
Yeah, well, you know, I find some people like to pick the Apo inducement, but I find it so much less effective.
No, babes are awesome until you roll double ones. Like, and then you just sort of like curse yourself.
Or when every hit becomes a casualty instead of a...
Yeah.
Let's see. Do I want to be there or there? I think I want to be here.
Always super annoys me when you're playing someone like Wood Elves or something like that. And you keep busting armor and you keep getting them on the off the field, but you just can't Kaz anyone. It's just like literally knockout, knockout, knockout. And you're like, come on, man.
Oh, that's turnover. Well, fair
yes.
enough. No, Carlshen! Hey, look, babes. Value. At least your guy's down too, otherwise I would be in a bit more of a mess.
Would be a little bit more of a pickle, yes.
Yes, exactly. Wow. Pickleton. Now I've only got one player more than you do.
It's true. This is absolutely true. Factually correct, as some might say. Decisions.
Nah, highly overrated those.
I'm never a big fan of making decisions. I prefer just to like let the dice fall where they may. Kind of attitude.
Just wait until it's too late to make one.
Yeah, that's always good. Let the timer run out.
Ah, I like this. This is a good move.
Come on, Mighty Blow. Oh, you're rubbish. Mighty Tickle.
Yeah, well. That's okay. It won't bother you for long.
Better not. All right, my god. God away. Let's go crazy.
Oh, wow. Decisions.
Gotta be aggressive, you see, Sage. Can't mess around.
Well, wait for the natural course of things, then that might be worse, yeah. So you've got guard there and there. That's kind of annoying.
Yeah. Guard, great in tandem. They're like Starsky and Hutch of the Orc world.
Definitely, okay. Definitely true.
AKA Snotcock and Dickrag, in case you're wondering. That's the name of the players. I didn't name them. Yes,
I did. Oh, man.
Apparently, the names of my players causes the guys who do like the recap for like the weekly recap show. It causes them all kinds of issues because they really try and avoid using, you know.
Oh,
dirty
really?
Words.
Yeah, that's so sad for them.
Why you got a double skull, man? I mean, double power.
Well, I got a double skull before. I just flipped them over. Don't rattle the dice cup, and you're fine. Here, there,
everywhere.
Hello.
Sorry.
Stuns.
I care nothing of stuns. The way I see a stun, can't get hurt for another two turns.
Well.
I'm kind of all right.
Yeah, I'm not inclined to put my ball carrier there.
Yeah. You should, though. It's a good move. I've heard that.
Yeah, this is iffy as well, actually. Let's just knock this guy down first. Oh!
Yes, that's it. More moral victories.
That's pretty bad.
Yeah, right.
So what I could do... I've got one assist here, so that's a one die. I've already blitzed, so that's not good. Going here... isn't really safe, is it? I do want that assist in.
Would like to point out, I'm not actually watching your stream either. I wouldn't want to be one of those people who's spying in, you know, to see where you said going here is not an option. I don't know where going here is.
Oh, okay. Well, it's fine. I mean, if I didn't want to tell you, then I probably shouldn't be talking out loud with you on Skype.
It's true. true, but yeah. Just thought I'd point that out. I'm a fair player. Fair player.
Yeah, I used to worry about that, and then I thought, well, fuck it. If it brings value to the stream, then...
No, that's true. That's true. Look at it that way. But, I mean, again, it would be on a little bit of a delay, isn't it, I think, anyway, so...
Yeah, it is. It is at that. Oh, so many options.
So many.
So one die here would be kind of bad. If I make it a two die with a carrier, then he has to go down. Or it would be really bad. Huh.
What to do?
Much as I like causing my damage this early, I don't think I can afford to do that.
Well, I'm only a player down. It's all right.
I'm going to be a bit risky here.
Oh, look at you. You're crazy, man.
Yeah, I'm crazy like that. There you go. See? Everything's all right. Get that claw action working. Yeah. Risk reward.
Why have you got to fuck with my cock, man?
yeah. All right. So let's see. This is now relatively safe all of a sudden. Which means I can afford to make that block, but if it's a push, that's kind of sucky. Can I afford to go here? Sure. Get stuck in there. And give this guy a little smacking. Ah, come on, never lucky.
It's true. I do feel a bit bad about your luck.
Yeah, I know, right? Seriously. The hell, Nuffle.
An often lamented fault of the sages. Glaring lack of luck.
Yes. Yeah, I would have won the World Cup if it weren't for...
it weren't for those damn kids.
Damn middling kids. Yeah. No, I saw a nice post about that, actually, that the true moral of Scooby-Doo is that the real monsters are humans. I thought, that's all right.
It is true. And kids as well.
And kids,
everything.
Yes.
Especially for old people who like to do stuff to
them. Come on. Block is so OP. Seriously. Oh,
I tell you what's not overpowered. Mighty Blow on its own. Not the best. Have I blitzed yet? No, I haven't.
Let's find out. I don't think you have. I don't see any flash icons coming up.
No, I haven't blitzed. Just debating what I want to do. I hate debating stuff.
So since we have 4 minute turns, I can't actually make you lose track of time by talking. So how long have you been playing Blood Bowl for?
I used to play it as a youngster. Mm-hmm. I got into the tabletop version with my friends, but amazingly, it managed to cause like tons of arguments. Really loads of... No, but you know what it would be about? It would be about, oh, no, he started, like, you'd move your piece, and they'd be like, no, you moved them from the wrong spot or something like that, and it'd be like, no, I didn't, I moved them from... and then, you know...
Yeah, just... like tabletop war games, basically.
Yeah, and... hold on. Do I want to do... All right, hold on. No, don't want to do that. Might have to actually one dice. No. So yeah, that's how I got into Blood Bowl. And then as I got a bit older, I sort of just deliberately stopped playing. I was just sort of not playing as much. Mm-hmm. And then started playing online. Like here, like on well, I didn't actually play much of Blood Bowl 1. Like
all right.
But oh, look at that random Yes.
Murderer.
Yes.
Well, he's got 5-star player points. So I kind of have to he's fine. He's fine. Thanks, Doc.
Medic! I love this doctor!
Well, that almost evens the odds again.
Well, sort of, but not really. Just a little bit. It's horrible when you rely on.
He's got 5-star player points, but he can still get sure hands, Squiggy. Against the Wood Elves, I'm potentially even tempted to take tackle before block on a guy.
Well, I had a game against it was a Wood Elf team, and I wasn't going to take tackle on the guy who's got tackle, but because my next game when he skilled up was against Wood Elves, it was like, okay, tackle it is then.
Yeah, I probably Squiggy then. But we have 2 Wood Elves. Zacharel, you also played Zacharel, I think.
That was my last game, yeah. I think it was.
Let's see, I've got a block there, then a block there. This could go into there, which would give him a 2-die with claw. I've still got 2 rerolls. What I need to do is blitz that guy and get safe.
What you really need to do is give me the ball. That's what you need to do.
I'll do it. Sure. Turn 8. Turn 8, it's all yours. That is your turn 8, not my turn 8.
Oh, man. Come on, man. Why not on your turn 8? Actually, not on your 10-8. Do it on turn 5. Just give me the ball. Gives me time to get down there and maybe score.
Hey, did I mention claw all the things?
Yeah. That's like 5
on.
Already.
Come on. So if I put him there, then I'll need an assist, which I've already got here. This guy needs to stay right where he is.
Tell you a move that I see pros do all the time. You move your ball carrier right next to my prone dude and then foul him, all right? That's a pro move. That's what I've seen people do.
Look at it. I've got 3 block guys and somehow, yeah, just like that.
It's always the one, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. This is where I wanted to push. Yeah, that's definitely part of the plan.
The lightning bolt was putting me off there. I was like, oh, no, I'm all right now. And I'm like, oh, crap. No, I'm not.
Yeah. Oh!
Yes! Don't re-roll it. Oh, you bastard.
Yeah, I mean, kill all the orcs, right? I mean, this is a worthy target, too.
Yeah, no, fair enough.
Smack! Yeah!
Man, you and your claw toenails.
Toenails, indeed.
Oh, miss toenails. The next game?
Aww, toenails so OP.
They are.
All right. This is cleaning up nicely. And this guy, despite appearances, does not have movement 7. Splendid.
No, that's it. Not that I want them to clutter the screen up more, but because I play with the icons up. But it would be nice to know when certain players, like without having to hover over them, if they've got like some sort of niggle.
I know, right? Well, if they would say remove the starting skills.
Yes.
So that your dwarves don't show block, tackle, and thick skull. Precisely. And then remove the black boxes that go from, hey, there's another row here, but it's not actually full, but we just made it black anyway. There would be plenty of room to show injuries, especially minus armors and niggles, because I really want to see those.
Yeah, that seems like too much common sense, though, Serge. That's the problem.
Yeah, I don't really. Yeah,
they're not a big fan of that.
Well, actually, I found them to be pretty receptive to arguments at times. I can't really get into specifics, but
right,
they,
okay.
Yeah, it's a legal
to certain arguments.
Okay. Yeah,
as long as your argument is well constructed, is that what you're saying?
Yeah, and you actually post it in a spot where they bother to read it. That helps.
Is that often a little
bugbear? I mean, if you post like Steam discussions, they're not going to read that.
Right.
Oh, where's this guy going? Is he going to be a Knorring threat next turn?
I was debating it. Oh, that's good. I really
there. Maybe he's trying to get away.
He doesn't want to be part of the Khan.
Maybe if I go this way, he won't claw me.
Yeah, he's seen all of his brethren get there.
Yeah.
Their grubby orc asses handed to them, and he's like, nah. I've got agility, man. I'm getting out of here.
I've got agility and no apo.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's for me. Yeah.
That makes sense. Yeah, so if you make me screw up and roll a 1 in 9 here, I might be in some trouble.
Well, you know, it's always tempting.
However, I could also do that and this. Can I get there, though? Can I get there? Not really until I've done that. So I could get here. Turn 5, I've got time. And then... you're just going to go keep him busy. That's good.
What's some more I see over there, eh? Okay, fair enough. That Chaos Warrior is going to get it.
And then here. And then... this one. Oh, hey, look, it's pushes. So sad. I hate rolling pushes. Oh, wait, I don't. Pushes are good now.
Yeah, wait till you quad
thing.
Wait till you quad skull, though. You ain't going to be saying that then.
Mm-hmm. Sure. I'll wait. How long should I wait for, though? 4 or 5
about,
games?
Is that going to be enough? About 3 minutes and 12 seconds.
Just keep waiting.
Yeah,
just wait. I like that. So unfortunately, Claw is not doing anything right now.
Oh! Ooh,
but the crowd likes it. The crowd likes it. Yeah, yes. Sparta.
Sorry, I'll be back for the next game.
Did you say guard do well in pairs? Yeah, I think you said that.
Maybe.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure you said that. Well, that's okay. You can join him later.
So you can't expect me to, you know, keep tabs on everything that I've said, Sage.
No, it's fine. It's
too,
fine.
It's too much. All right.
Yes, we're going to run out of orcs. That is the plan. No, Diog, International Caps Lock Day is Saturday, which is why I'm not streaming on Saturday. That's right.
Is that a thing, International Caps Locks Day?
Yeah, it's a thing, and it's Saturday.
Live this Saturday. what happens on International Caps Locks Day?
I think you can probably guess.
A lot of caps locking.
People spam caps lock. Yes, it's a thing.
If only I could have pushed that other guy a little bit more.
Yeah, I was wondering whether you were setting up for a surf there. It would have been possible. But you have to start off with a half die, which is, you know.
Yeah, it wasn't something that I wanted to necessarily risk.
Yeah, I can see that.
I felt it was not the right thing to do.
I actually realized later that I missed International Talk Like a Pirate Day. I think I streamed and no one told me. I was so upset.
Well, you know what? I'd blame your viewers.
Yes. When in doubt.
When in doubt, blame them. Yeah, you lot. Yeah. It's all your fault.
Yeah, I would have won the World Cup, but I got distracted because I was streaming.
I would have won the World Cup. Absolutely. But my damn viewers put me off. Thanks a lot, yeah. Viewers. You know what? I think I'm going to one dice this. I don't care.
Like a boss.
I know. See, that's what pros do. Oh, and they injure people as well. Come on.
No. Yes. Oh, Skitsunio. Skitsunio, my block guy. Ooh. My dead block guy. Ooh. Yep. He's gone.
I'd blame your viewers for that too as well.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely all their fault.
You know what? I can do this. I've got four, basically three turns left. There we go.
Oh, and a pow. Are we even in numbers now? You've got four guys out. I've got three guys out. Yeah.
Yeah, but no, you've only got five out. You've only got one guy out. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I know what I mean. I know what you mean. Next half is going to be different. So ideally, I'd blitz with him, which would require blocking there. Have to keep tabs on the turns a little bit. I have to think about how I can get that safe as well.
Sounds solid keeping tabs on turns. Turns, you don't want to do that. Just play, enjoy yourself.
Just Crendor it, yeah.
It's just, you know. When the ref blows for half time, he blows for half time. Who's to say? You know, just
play. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so this is a bit of a risk. If I go here, well, that makes things better. A little bit. A little bit. I'm willing to risk this 1-9. There we go. It's all good, man. It's all good.
Yes! Yeah. No armor break either.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5 would be here. A push would kind of suffice there. 1-9 here would kind of suck, maybe.
1-9. 1-9.
No! Denied. Denied. Did you say tackle? I don't care about tackle.
Even do I, for the most part.
Yeah, not for this matchup, no.
Tackle's one of those skills where it's like, when you actually need it, it's like, oh, tackle's the best. But when you don't need it, it's like, oh, man, tackle?
Yeah. Do I really have to invest in that shit?
Yeah. Stupid tackle.
All right, so we're going to go here.
Next
and then we're going to go there.
Next to my down Black Orc. That seemed like a good spot.
Yeah, as long as I'm not there. One, this guy doesn't have movement 7. Seriously. I know this, and still I see this icon, and I go, wait, I have to count that out. 2, 4, 6, 8. Yeah, not a problem. Not a problem at all. This will do. Yeah, this looks kind of secure-ish. Yeah.
It's only secure until my +1 agility dude goes through the middle.
Yeah, of course.
Then it stops being a bit secure.
Oh. Yeah, true. You could do that.
I could do that. But...
I could. Yes.
I mean, it's almost... you know what's annoying me? Like, if the two dudes who were screening him were actually Chaos Warriors, I would do it.
I could suck a dick.
I'd be like, well...
Nothing, there's nothing
too much annoying
about
to try and get two dice on them, but I kind of feel like
dick.
I can get two dice on a...
I could.
On a goat.
I'll show you the video.
I've got Mighty Blow right nearby. Decisions. Well...
Yeah, so you've basically got 5 players to play around with. 4.
What is that dodging there, anyway? 33% with a reroll. Yep.
50%. Yeah, it's about 50-50 with the reroll.
Alright, well...
The problem is you need this guy to make it a 1-die.
Yeah.
But if it goes out of bounds, it could stop the score. It won't get you the touchdown, but it could stop the score. That's worth investing in. Ooh.
It's one of those where, like, it's a better chance, I think, of stopping you from scoring than allowing you to get anyone.
Oh, that's nice.
And plus, he's on the floor now. It's a bit hard, unless you want to foul him, but, you know.
Yeah, well, if I considered the bribe. So this is no claw. I'm not going to blitz there. So...
There's not another Chaos team in the league, is there? Or in Division 3? Or is there?
I don't think so. No, I don't think so.
I'm just trying to think how much more claw there is. I know he's got like two Mighty Blow werewolves, I think, in his Necro
really?
Team. I think
the
so.
Fucker.
I know.
My Necro just refuse to roll either doubles or stats.
He's got one, but I'm pretty sure he's got two Mighty Blow guys. So Mighty Blow claws, which, you know.
So I could do it with this guy, but then there's no claw. I could do it with this guy. Ah, that's all right. That's all right. Yeah, let's do this first. Because reasons.
Because stuff.
Yes, exactly. Stuff.
It's the best reason ever.
I know, right? Yeah, so this way I can use my claws and still, if it fails,
keep clawing
you. Not be too at risk. Yeah, exactly. Keep clawing you and not be too exposed.
Yes.
The failure.
Moral victory number
yes.
7 or 8. Loving it.
Yeah. Yeah. I plan on giving you many more chances at such a victory.
Wait till the Berg787 propaganda machine kicks in after this one. Moral victory. That's all that matters. Sort of. Where are you going? Stay here. Why? Just stay where you are. Don't run over there with your claw, man.
Oh. Did you have plans for him?
Well, you know, a little dance. That's what I was going to do with him. But he obviously didn't want to oblige.
Yeah, no. He's got bigger plans than that. Next half, Gadget. Next half.
That shouldn't have made me laugh as much as it did, but it did. Nice. I don't know why.
I know that feeling. You're like, wait, why am I laughing? This is a bad joke. This is terrible, but I can't help myself. Yeah, I know that one.
Next time. All right. Oh, that actually made me a bit lightheaded as well. I think I need a cigarette.
Yeah, too bad that you don't have the mutual consensual pause option here. That would be
yeah, like on Fumble? Yeah, that would be good. Yeah. Like, can I just take a time out? Yeah.
Halftime smokes? Sure. Yeah. Oh, really? With the Mighty Blow and everything? And I don't have an Oppo.
Come on. Yes, come on.
Oh, he's fine. You know you've got to foul that now, right? I mean, it's like a rule or something.
I haven't got anyone to get over there to foul him.
Yeah, sure you do.
My Black Orc, I suppose.
Yeah.
Or I could dodge out with it, yeah. I suppose in a way, if he does get sent off, it does save him from a clawing. So
technically, you know. On a 3-3-2-2, your lineman could do it. I would probably I wouldn't do it with the Black Orc, but I would probably try with the lineman. I mean, if he fails, you're just rolling against armor 9, and if he succeeds, brilliant.
I don't know if I really. I almost feel like you're patronizing me there. Like, yeah.
No,
yeah,
no. Course,
I'll give you a few tips here, rookie. I'll
tell you something about me. So I take my gaming pretty seriously, and I play board games with friends quite a bit, and they are always looking for the catch in my advice, but I don't actually give bad advice because I take a sort of meta point. Oh, that's a bad dodge though. Wrong square. I take a meta point of view where...
I wasn't dodging him out to try and foul.
Yeah. Oh, okay, I see. Huh?
Just for sure. No, I'm just dodging. Actually, no, I do want him to get punched. No, I don't want him to get punched. I'm a little confused.
So I kind of take the meta point of view that if my co-gamers know that I never give bad advice, then they don't constantly have to think about, wait, why is he telling me this? They know there's something in it for me, but you know, in a 4 or 5 player game, you can often give people advice that's sensible, but also in your favor, and then give them the advice that's sensible, but in against you.
Well,
so
basically,
people know they have to just listen to me, basically.
Well, it's kind of like you're giving them the meantime advice, which would be good, but in the long term, it could actually benefit you. But for the immediacy, it is actually not a bad move or whatever.
Well, usually it means that I give them advice when their best move is also good for me, and then I shut up if their best move is bad for me.
Right,
and, you know,
okay.
In a 4 or 5 player game, it's non-zero sum, basically. I can help you fuck him over because I like to see him fucked over. Stuff like that.
What would you say I should do against Claw, eh?
Don't play orcs.
Yeah, no. Well, I was prepared for this, but you know, never know. Good little beat up here when on my turn 8. We'll see what happens. Is this guy going to replace the niggling guy then? The guy who just scored?
This guy is. If he survives, he might get sure hands.
I think
having one sure hands against Squeeze Wood Elves is probably the best bet.
Does he have strip? Because I played him first, I think. So like he was.
I think you played him twice already, actually.
Oh yeah, I played him in. I played him in the spin games as well. That was it. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. This guy's got 5, 0, and 6, and this guy's got 0. So let's make sure my strip ball survives this turn. My sure hand survives this turn. Now watch him roll agility, and I'll get all upset.
I'm only.
Why am I doing this? I'm playing against orcs. I'm just too neurotic not to.
Don't be doing it. It's a bad thing. All right, I tell you what. If I injure these 3 dudes, we're in business.
Sure. Yeah.
That's my plan. That's exactly my plan.
Sounds like a solid plan, actually.
I thought it was a pretty good plan as well. Some people said no, but I say yes. Where's this mic?
All right, how disgustingly bad is it, Squiggy? Nope, I don't earn money from Twitch ads because I'm not a partner. But if you're watching this on YouTube, then yes, disabling your ad blocker for this channel would actually help me out.
Yeah, man, don't block ads. Block ads when you're viewing like music or something like that. Don't block ads when you view us. We're the little man. We're the little guy. You know, we need to make a crumb. Big corporations. Screw them over. What have they ever done for you? Nothing.
Yes.
So, yeah, ad block for them, not for us.
That's right. There's actually a plugin thing that lets you specifically disable your ad blocker for specific YouTube channels automatically.
Oh really? Well, get that.
I've got it. A link to the description down here in my Twitch.
You're gonna say in your pants.
Thingy.
I'll look at that.
Perfect defense. Oh yeah, that doesn't really help you much, does it?
Up a little bit.
Yeah, I can get away from the block guys a bit. But you're still going to blitz with that guy, so that doesn't matter. It helps a little bit, yeah. Yeah, that it does.
Ooh, that helps. Love it when that happens. All right.
Yeah, this is the perfect time for it. Now watch weather change back into rain next turn.
Don't say that. That's just really do I really even... Can I make 3 dice on this guy?
Could, but not while also making a pass.
Yeah, precisely.
Well...
I could, but I can.
If you free up the tackler.
Yeah.
If you free by blocking with the wrestler.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking as well.
Yeah. There we go. Wrestle. So OP.
You down anyway. Take that.
This is the guy you appoed, right?
Yeah, I did appo him. So there you go. See? Good thing I appoed him.
Yeah, instant value.
Instant. That wouldn't have happened if he hadn't been appoed. What are you laughing for? It's true.
No, I wasn't laughing.
It's absolutely true.
Yeah. Factually.
Factually correct.
Yes. Oh, look at that. So much pow.
I feel like following up and make it hurt.
Yeah, it feels like it's more likely to cause damage if you follow up, doesn't it?
No, you know what I found? When it's against me, anyway. When the people are umming and ahhing over whether to follow up, that's when I feel like I always get injured. You know, when someone's like, do I want to follow up? And you're waiting for them to make the decision.
Yeah, the suspense. Yeah, the suspense is killing.
I know that's absolute, you know, bollocks. It's not true, but it just feels that way.
Yeah.
I always think it is.
Yeah, psychology is pretty screwed up, actually. Huh. If that guy had had block instead of wrestle, you would have had a 3 die here.
Yeah, I know. You don't need to mock. So.
You've got a reroll. You could even GFI for the three die.
No.
But yeah, no. There you go.
It's a motto that I live by.
Ah, all the stuns. Tis but a scratch.
All right. Oh man, you can't get in for this assist. Or you can. I have to go for it. All right.
I'm gonna pass,
but I want to go for it.
If I fail to go for it,
then I'll just foul him. But if he makes the go for it, then I'll pass.
Oh, you picked the 5-star player point guy too, didn't you?
No, I picked my thrower.
I mean to foul. I had two guys with 0 and one guy with 5.
That was completely coincident.
Yes, of course.
It wasn't. No. It wasn't planned.
No malicious intent at all.
I wish I was that well planned that far ahead.
And smack.
Ow.
Snake eyes. Aw, that's brutal. Sorry about that. My lungs are still...
Cough away.
Yeah. Yeah, I always try to remember to mute my mic before I do that. There we go.
Doesn't bother me.
Wake the hell up.
I'd like to think that if I hadn't actually fouled, those ones would have been used for your knockout roll.
Actually, technically, that's probably how the shit works. Yeah.
Good job, Berg.
So thank you for that foul. Yeah. It was most helpful.
Indeed. I really wish I hadn't.
Yeah, that's often the case after the fact.
Well, it's because I probably didn't really need to because it wasn't fouling anyone important. And I was only a man down at that stage as well. And if your guy happened to not come back on, we would have been level on players.
Yeah, but, you know, you were in a situation where the status quo was not going to cut it.
Yeah, true.
So you needed something to break that. And I think in that sense, it wasn't that bad a choice.
Well, I feel better. I feel better about that. And that's not me being patronizing or sarcastic. Thanks.
No worries. I didn't hear it as such either. Let's see. I've got better on this side, so let's switch that up. 2, 4, 6, 8. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Huh.
Tell you what would be awesome right now. Of rock up its throne and mashes up one of your... Mashes up... I don't know which one I particularly want to hurt more. The Chaos Warrior.
The blood ones, yeah. Yeah. Whichever.
Which one? Probably the Chaos Warrior one, actually, because the Beastman one probably easier to get off the field by myself. So.
Yeah, that's true. That's definitely how I think about those things. Like, well, if I'm going to foul with 30 player or a Surf, then I'd rather hit the Armor 9 guy, because at least the Armor 8 guy I can kill by my own.
Yeah,
on
it's
my
easier
own.
To do.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. Thought about it. No, I'm not going to put my warriors on the line. If I had removed your other guard already, then I would have gone warriors on the line.
You'd have tried to overpower me, eh?
Yeah, I outnumber you quite a bit. If I can pull all of your guys down the center to get your blocks in, then you're going to be very exposed.
Sage, you outnumber me right now by quite a bit, but you just wait until this turns over.
Well, that's the other part of the logic. Yeah, yeah. That's what you said last turn, right? And then you lost a guy to fouling.
Look at it this way. I've got to be right sooner or later. That's how statistics work, isn't it?
At some point, you'll say something along the lines of, hey, I think I'm going to lose this game.
Yeah. Well, you know what? It's like those people who say it's the end of the world. Well, eventually it will be. You know, they'll be right one day.
Yeah, yeah.
It's the people who bet on it that I don't get. It's like, how are you cashing in that bet?
Yeah, exactly. Like... How satisfied can you get by finally being right and not getting to say I told you so?
Yeah, that's, not even being able to cash in.
Yeah,
like, you can't even go down to your local bookies and say, "All right, pay up now." End of the world. He's going to say, "Screw you." End of the world.
Yeah.
All right, let's start by punching you.
Nope.
All right. I know. It was a no. I need to rub it in. Huh. That's not a no, though, is it?
Nope. No. That is. A 7, huh? You know what you need?
Claw.
Claw, no, mighty blow.
Yeah. Yeah. It's true.
There you go. Mighty blow. Straight up 5.
Yeah, this is fantastic.
All right. That's 2 out of 3. Or 2 out of 4, actually.
Just because I want to.
Orcs on the field.
Yeah, why are they on the field? Go up there, Black Orc, and get beat up next turn. But for now, you're doing me a good service.
There you go. Third die is the charm. Oh, wait. That's not right. What I'm saying.
Almost. Sort of. Don't know why Auld Lang Syne came in. Had the
good stuff. Okay. This looks interesting.
Damn right it's interesting.
Oh yeah, someone's pointing out that you didn't blitz. I didn't actually notice this because
I didn't blitz, but like, who was I going to go and blitz?
Yeah,
like I would have blitzed one of the beastmen had I not knocked them all down with blocks. But I mean, yeah, in theory, I could have ran over like my lineman and my black orc over there to blitz one of your
warriors,
but they were a bit too stretched apart. Listen, Sage's viewers, I don't need advice from you. I got the Sage here. He's telling me what to do.
Yeah, I'm not biased at all, by the way.
No, I trust you. Well, you said that you give straight up advice, you know, when you compete.
I didn't say I would give all advice.
Oh, what?
I do that too, but then I charge money. I did that this afternoon. It was great fun, actually.
Was it a bit of a tutorial session?
Yeah, there was a guy from Thailand, actually, who wanted to hire me to teach him to play Skaven. Yeah.
Really?
Cool. Yeah.
I know. Did you ask for payment up front? Or?
Yeah. Well, we discussed a fee, and he paid the first lesson up front. Yep.
All right. That's pretty good.
We're going to be doing a couple more over the next couple of weeks. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. It's that's a first. And there was quite some interest from other viewers to do the same. So I played it live here on the stream, which means people had the chance to see what it's like and also learn from it a bit. And I had some other people who thought, hey, this actually looks like something I would like to do myself. So yeah, maybe there's
there's a market for it.
Growth potential there. Yeah, market. I mean, I'm hoping to turn my gaming and my streaming into something of an income. And
yeah, no,
if I can do that, if I can do that via lessons rather than ads or stuff, yeah, that's cool.
No, absolutely.
Oh, I like that spot. That's perfect. Yeah, because then he goes there. And then that guy goes there. And look at them. They're still doing their bloody job. Splendid.
Amazing, isn't it?
Yeah.
Who'd have thunk it?
Yeah, actually, I have thought about that as well, Diog. So, in my day-to-day life, I teach cognitive neuroscience in university, and I was actually considering the option of trying to see how classes on that would work on YouTube, for instance. I don't think Twitch is quite the medium for it, but YouTube could definitely work.
That sounds like a made-up job.
Teaching cognitive neuroscience.
Just get a fry out there. Sounds made up.
I can see that. No, yeah, it's actually the case, though.
If I wanted to lie about what I did and have no one check up on whether I was lying, I would say that as well.
Okay, well...
Because who's going to prove you wrong? Like, unless there's another cognitive neuroscientist.
There are people in chat who have read part of my PhD thesis. Damn, I hate that word.
It is a rough word, I agree with you.
Yes, thank you. Words in general are kind of sucky, but yeah.
Just true. Do I want a 50-50 dodge out or get punched by Mighty Blow Claw and hope that you wouldn't die?
How about both?
What, like that as I dodge out, you hurt me with Mighty Blow Claw?
No, I'm just brain farting here. I thought you had two guys there, but that's actually my warrior.
Yeah. It is.
Yeah, the people in chat who know my real name, which is probably everyone by now because I keep screwing up the window capture stuff, they've probably found me.
What are people saying? How do they know you? Do I want to make this block? Not particularly, but I'll re-roll it if I fail. Ah, I didn't fail. That's enough.
Enough of a non-failure.
Yeah. That's moral victory there, Sage. Can't get enough of them. No, I have heard that you are a neuroscientist or something like that. At least someone called you that. You should remain unnamed. He's always really angry, though. I don't know why. He always just seems really miserable.
Who? Someone?
Someone, yeah.
A certain someone who shall not be named. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's true. I'm not sure whether how much of that is specifically in relation to me and how much of it is just him in general, but yeah.
I'm not knocking him. I watch some of his stuff. I enjoy his stuff, but he does seem always really miserable. I'm like, cheer up, yeah. Man.
Yeah. Yeah, that's... I can see how you might have that opinion.
I don't know. Well, at least it was only a man with block. I say that before you've knocked me down. All right, it's okay. It was. So worried.
All right, so now we've got this guy there. We can get this guy here. Keep you a bit under wraps there.
I'll just dodge out again. You don't know about Pissface, man. He's the master of dodging. That's his modus operandi.
Let's hit this guy. Because he's got wrestle. That way, if I hit them both down, then you've got a pretty nasty choice to make.
It's not that big a choice. I'll be straight up with you. It'd be wrestle.
Yeah, exactly. So I don't need block. You've got wrestle. Yeah. All right. So that's a useful stun. Even if it's not huge just yet. If I go here, yeah, I like that. It's worth one GFI though. Let's see. Oh, my mouse is screwing up. Are you hacking my mouse, Berg?
Yes, screw up for another 2 minutes 50. We're good. You pretty much had this turn anyway. So screw up for another half an hour and we'll call it quits.
We'll call it a tie.
Yeah.
We'll call it a draw. Yeah. Huh.
How we play next touchdown wins. There we go.
I suspect it will, actually, yes. Yeah. All right, GFI, because we can. There we go.
Not to jinx anyone, then. There hasn't been a lot of GFIs, but none have been failed so far. By either.
You might be right.
I am right. I've got a play in my head here.
Oh, no. You've got a play in your head?
Yeah, it sounded weird. I've got a play.
Is it like a stage play or?
It's Macbeth.
Now you spoiled it. I was going to guess.
Oh, well, yeah. Pretend I didn't say Macbeth. Go on, free guesses.
Romeo and Juliet.
No.
Waiting for Godot.
No.
No. Is it? Does it have Muppets?
I don't know if they did a version of that.
Could be. Oh, there we go.
You want that? It's ruined my great play.
Oh, wow. This is a great play. I'm off. There's a skull in it, isn't there? There's a skull in the play. I'm sure of it.
No, there's anything but a one in the play. Time to potato. For all my worth.
Handoff. Yeah. 2+. Dodge. 2+. Yeah, it's not terrible.
Ah!
Oh, that's terrible, though. That's terrible. This had potential, because my guy in the back has movement 5. If you've made some GFIs there. Yeah, those skulls did screw you over.
Yeah, pretty, I mean, look, whatever. I could have failed one of the GFIs that I would have had to have done as well. So, you know, it happens. But
yeah, but not having the reroll that your play kind of depends on. Yeah, that sucks.
One thing I will say for those viewers who do watch me on my channel, like, I'm very much like, I never complain about luck. I don't. I get salty, but I don't like, oh, this guy's so lucky. Oh, I can't believe how unlucky I am. It's sort of like, you know, it is what it is. You can get annoyed, but
yeah, that's a very, very good quality. I approve wholeheartedly.
And I really despise it when the person starts shouting at you and arguing with you about luck, like starts calling you really lucky. It's like, oh, I leave me alone, man. It's like, so basically, if you were winning, it's because how great you are. But when you're not winning, it's, oh, well, you're just lucky. Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, sounds about right.
I tried to.
Yeah.
Who can
skill? None of them. Why don't I have anyone in skilling range? Because I also want to tackle on this guy. But that's way off. 20-0-0 Bad management, yeah.
Bad management. Should have had someone in range.
Mm-hmm.
Just thought I'd give you a free tip.
Risky. There we go. I do need a new welcome page on my YouTube. That's... I can definitely see how. Yeah. Wow, that was great sentencing there. Brilliant word stuff. Yeah, so this is okay. Shouldn't have followed that, should I? No, should not. You've got agility 4 there.
I do, yeah.
That's kind of...
kind of cool, isn't it?
Bad.
Some people might call it cool.
Yeah. There we go. Not a problem. In that case, you can go here and give this guy a little shove. Yeah, I've got 4 rerolls. Why have I... How the hell...
You got one on the kickoff, I think it was.
Must have done. Yeah. Can't afford to follow this up, can I? Because that would leave a serious gap from that angle. So, in that case... Who cares, because he's down anyway.
Well, I care.
Ah, yes.
Oh, yeah, there you go. Have that. See, that's
what happens. Actually, I think skulls there is better than a push. Maybe.
I get what you're saying. It's not quite, but it's not far off.
Yeah. Yeah. If you had a bit more strength left, then it would have been. But yeah. You could make this work. Yeah, the dual cam thing didn't work because Berg possibly is not wearing pants or has cam issues. We're undecided on the question.
What it is? It's because I'm so devilishly handsome. I didn't want to distract people.
That's gotta be it.
It's true. Well, you asked for the reason. I give you the reason. Then you don't like my reason.
There you go. Look at him. I mean, he's...
Look at me.
Yeah. Can't argue with that, can you? Anyway. your Skype avatar thingy. Oh, don't push buttons, Sage. Oh, you professional, you.
This is a really interesting turn. I don't know what I want to do. Alright. Nah, but that's rubbish as well.
Yeah, the problem is by the time you get somewhere that you can work with, all your players have acted.
That is a bit of a problem. And if I'm going to do that, I would just do it with him.
People are complimenting your attitude in chat, by the way.
Oh, thank you. I always worry that I sound sarcastic, but like that genuinely does mean something to me. So thank you, because I do try and keep a smile on my face.
Yeah, I a lot of people get really upset while playing Blood Bowl, and at some point I start wondering, why do you still bother?
No, absolutely, it's ridiculous. It's just sort of. If anything, I get more upset with myself when I know, because that's also another thing that's so key. It's like, yeah, all right, in theory, you can have an incredibly unlucky game where no matter what you do, you know, you're screwed. But most of the time, it's a combination of things.
Yeah,
it's a combination of your mistakes, which have led you to a situation where you've ended up needing to make dice rolls, which you probably wouldn't need to have done, And also, those people who moan about luck tend to always forget about the time that they, got lucky themselves.
If you start bitching about your luck,
not your dice.
Thank you, Casino. If you start bitching about your luck, that's 3 tackle zones. By the way, you could have gone into 2 there.
There you go. See, that's exactly. Yeah. That's, and I would have made it as well. I rolled the 4.
Oh yeah, you actually rolled the 4. Ouch.
Yeah, I wasn't thinking. I was ranting about.
Yeah, right. It's a strategy I use.
Oh, damn you. That's why you wanted me on this thing, to talk to you.
Now that this worked, I can brag about it.
It's amazing. But no, it is. I just think that a lot of the time, exactly what you said, though. Like, why play? Like, if you hate the game so much, or it's just a numbers game, it doesn't matter, it's just numbers, but out of luck, then why are you playing? Or if you genuinely think it's just out of luck, why are you getting angry then?
And you know the problem is that once you get that attitude, you stop learning.
Yeah.
Because you can't learn how to roll better dice, but you can learn how to avoid those screw-ups. And it's very counterproductive in that sense.
It is.
Right, so I've got two dice there already. If I two-die this guy, then I can go there. Assist. No, wait, that doesn't assist. What am I saying? Right now, I've got two there. Claw this. Free up that guy. Yeah, that's splendid. So I get my claw pushes. Wait, that's not right.
What are you trying to do?
get as many two-die blocks as I can.
Oh, okay. That old chestnut of a tactic, eh? All right.
Yeah, well, it works pretty well for chaos a lot of the time, especially when your opponent doesn't have agility or something. Ah, justice then.
It's all right.
So I've got a one die here, and I've got a two die here, and this one is against armor 8.
Yeah, but see, Turd Lobber's the man. He doesn't get knocked over so easily. It's all those turds he loves.
Yeah, I guess that's absolutely right.
Except... You really wanted to knock him down. Does he not even hit me with Mighty Blower, yeah?
Well, no, but you've got armor 8.
It's funny like how
half a claw.
No, it's true. It is funny how like armor 8, all of a sudden when you're playing against the Orcs, that one armor 8 dude becomes like, all right, gotta get in.
The runners and the berserkers, troll slayers on dwarf teams.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, you go like, oh, look at that juicy target. If he were on a wood elf team, he'd be the tank, right? Yeah.
Indeed.
Oh, that's nasty.
I could almost do it. I would have done it.
Yeah.
But I can't. I would have gone for
it.
It wouldn't have even been that bad one. It would have been a 3+, 4+.
Yeah, I didn't count it out either. Mm. I just got lucky there.
Damn you. Sage luck. What can you do?
It would actually be just a 4+.
It would have, yeah, of course. So there we go, just a 4+. Rolled a 4+ last time. Could have done that last time, but didn't.
Yeah. No, because you didn't roll a 4+, you failed a 5+. That's vastly different. Yeah.
Technicalities. Well, all right, let's try and punch some of your dudes. Make me feel better.
Aww.
Yes.
Glenn Knowles.
He's
all right for now. Oh, more punching.
Yeah, we love punching. Punching's all right.
Yeah. Well, it's a good thing, too, because you're getting it.
Yeah, I am. It's true. If you don't punch someone, hard to knock them down. Not impossible, but hard.
Oh, guard doing a thing. You get another 2-die.
I need to cancel them out, that's why.
And as a little bonus, I get to claw you. Good trade-off. I like that. Carlshin again. Didn't he die before? I think so.
He did, yeah. He was the dude who actually died. Killed.
Carlshin is actually named after the 1-week-old son of one of my viewers.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yeah.
Congratulations to them.
Yeah. Black Books has a son now. Best of luck to him and his family. Let's see.
Black Books Volume 2.
Yes, the next generation.
That was a bad one.
Yeah. Books.
Nothing like a books.
Yes.
Incredibly brilliant. Funny.
it seriously took me this long to realize what you were saying. That was that was potentially worse than the joke itself.
I'll give you a break. It's an hour later where you are than where six. I'm probably a bit tired.
Well, I usually stream quite late, so I should be used to it. But yeah.
True. So plus, what can we do?
Sorry?
you were entertaining earlier as well, weren't you? You were wife's friends.
Yeah, my wife had had friends over, that's right.
Did you get to see him? The way you're saying it is if you were like kept out of view or something like that.
No, it was just these. You know, some people are your joint friends, and some people.
Oh right,
are,
right, right. Okay.
I mean, I get along with them, but they're really her friends. Yeah, so I wasn't that involved in the whole. I mean, we had dinner together, and then I brought the kids to bed and sat behind my PC chatting on Discord and stuff.
Sweet.
Right, I don't actually need to make this stall work for me, so that's kind of nice. So might as well make this a 3-die, I guess.
Could do that.
Who needs tackle anyway, right?
It's true. You'd be doing me a favor probably if you kill him.
Yeah.
On the valley. Go on, kill him. See, claw overrated. So I see it.
Yeah. Absolutely. Straight up 11s. If he had Mighty Blow piling on, he could have done this. But yeah, Claw got in the way.
Is Spoony still watching? Is he in the stream? In the chat?
Don't see it. Why?
Because he's playing you next, right?
Oh, is that so? I have to admit, I'm in 5 scheduled leagues right now.
All right, so you're
and I kind of don't really keep track of who I'm playing when, as long as I've got my calendar together, then I don't really.
No, I was thinking of 30 bad manners fouling, but no, I won't do that.
You could. I mean,
well, you know what though? With this much time left in the game, I don't think it is bad manners because that guy can mighty blow me, and that can hurt me.
Yeah, so, yeah, true.
That's
you
my
might want to do it with your best player because then he's safe.
Then he, yeah, no, it's true. I'm not going to do that though. I'm going to force you to try and score.
I'm gonna score.
All right.
Because Eidolon.
Okay, well then I take back the try part then, okay? Mm-hmm. You're right. Yeah. Force you to score.
Yeah, oh you were right. Finally.
There we go.
Yeah.
It's good being
no,
right.
I think Eidolon is gonna score 2 touchdowns this game. That sounds like a splendid idea. Dare I risk stuff? Of course I dare risk stuff. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I can 3-die a black orc. That sounds
me.
Fun.
That'll
yeah.
Work. Bad manners, some would say.
But
I don't know who those sums are, but
probably Lupak. Sounds like something Lupak would say.
Yeah. Silly bad manners. I don't think there's anything. I don't think there's such thing as bad manners. You know what's bad manners? Taking about 10 minutes. Well, you can't take 10 minutes, but taking like the full 4 minutes to take your turn when it's like there's not really
much
to do.
You could take 10 minutes.
Oh, yeah, you can if you do this wait while
15
deciding.
Second. Yeah.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Yeah, if you play against Asuet or Siamon, you can take 10 minutes. Hi, guys.
Like, I get it in certain points of the game. Like, there's, you know, crucial moments you want to take a little bit more time. But, like, I've played against some dudes, like, in random ladder matches where, like, then how can it take you so long to work out what you're doing? Like every single turn.
It could be a tactic to try and make you concede. Like
true.
If I waste enough of his time, maybe he'll stop playing and give up and say, fuck this, I'm going to get a real match.
Because I find that much worse bad manners than like turn 16 fouling. I don't care if someone turn 16
I agree.
Fouls me. It is what it is, you know?
Yeah.
It's in the game. Although it would be funny if like in a league format that like dirty players could get like suspended. Oh great, missing next game. Could get like suspended for getting sent off and stuff like that. So they miss the next game or something.
Yeah. So they'd have a reputation basically.
Yeah.
I think that would also be interesting. Like if a player builds up a reputation for regular fouling, that the ref is more likely to spot them.
Kind of like the old "I've got my eye on you" rule and stuff like that.
Yeah, I never played under that rule. I started playing in when CRP got released on Fumble.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. That's you only got one guy back.
It's a full box.
6. 2, 4, 6. So it's now 10 versus 6, right? Still got your garter. That's cheating.
Can't get rid of it. Oh, you got rid of my thrower? Why'd you do that, man?
Well, you know that armor 8 thing.
That's just me.
Yeah, I'm like that. Right. So let's see if we can make this a little tough for you. 3, 6, 0, 5. And then you hear.
I wish orcs had horns. Why don't black orcs have horns? I mean, they've all got them on their helmets.
Yeah, we but helmets, I mean, if you try and do that with a helmet, then the helmet comes off.
Ah, I see what you're saying. That's a good point. Never thought about that. What about if you strapped it on really tightly? You know.
Remind yourself that overconfidence like is a slow and insidious like killer.
I'm pretty sure I could put horns on my head. And they'd work pretty good. Maybe not like Beastman horns, but similar to.
The horns on the rat ogre, if you give it, look pretty cool, by the way.
Really? Oh, what did I see? Someone, I was playing against someone the other day, and they had something on a rat ogre that I hadn't seen before. Or was it on a minotaur? I think they gave like their minotaur like prehensile tail or something like that. And it looked kind of cool. I thought it was a bit of a waste, but it looked cool. You still there?
Yeah, I'm just looking at chat because people are saying there's a game. I see a black screen. This doesn't sound good.
Oh, right. Okay. Is the game black screened?
The game hasn't, but the stream has.
All right, that's not good.
Beards are good.
Beards are good. I agree with you. You can't trust a man who doesn't have a beard. That's what I say.
Well, they're hiding their face, aren't they?
Yeah. No. I'm saying you can't trust a man who doesn't have a beard because you're not hiding your face. You're showing everyone how awesome you are.
Yeah, that's what I mean. People
say it the other way around.
Confused about the Twitch stuff. So people say that people with beards hide their face, but I feel like people who shave hide their beards. That's what I meant to say. That was way better when I said it right the second time, wasn't it? Yeah.
I suppose I could move up here, but then it kind of messes up my...
This is either a very good or a very bad kick.
I think my man's under... Oh, no, he's not under it. All right, okay. For some reason, there was like a little black mark there. I just thought it was the shadow, and I moved over there.
Ah, I see. Yeah, you're chasing your own shadow.
Basically.
Wow. That's about troll-level player intelligence there.
All right. Okay.
So your quick snap means that you can block a lot more players here.
I can do, but I give up some blocks.
Yeah, if you had a full squad of lizardmen, that would be splendid. But with half a squad of orcs, not so much.
That was a pretty decent kick for you.
Yeah, I don't mind that at all. Yeah, I was just saying the other day that the orc thrower should really have his pass skill replaced by kickoff return and then just be renamed to the Orc Walker.
Maybe. Kickoff return. I wouldn't actually mind if they could just replace the pass with movement 6. I'd be all right.
Yeah, that would work, but I kind of like the movement 5 kickoff return thing.
The movement 5 thing does hamper him quite a bit. But
yeah.
Yeah,
but pass just doesn't help him enough.
It does actually when you've got an agility 4 blitzer. You'd be surprised. It's actually saved my bacon. But it's like an emergency play.
Yeah,
but
I have an agility 4 strength 5 blitzer on fumble. He's nice. He's got frenzy and guard, I think. That's good. I like that. Oh, pushes. Also nice.
I'm okay with it. I've come to peace with all this.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, dude, what the hell? Wow.
To be fair, we both rolled double skulls this game. I've rolled it twice, you've rolled it once, I think. So.
Yeah. To be fair, this game was never going to be close, probably.
Based on the matchup? Yeah, I needed to get lucky with Kaz rolls, basically. I needed to really mash you up early in the game.
Yeah, and, to have a shot.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's Claw's the kind of matchup that's kind of supposed to go one way. Oh, and it's your garter that's down too.
Yeah. That's why I was saying at the sort of beginning of the matchup, I was like, I really wish I'd played you in like week 1 or something like that.
Yeah, that would have made a huge difference. Absolutely. Let's see if we can knock you. Nope. In that case, I'd rather have you stay where you are. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Actually, let's go do that first. I like that. And GFI is good again.
Yeah, they've not been bad, the GFIs. Not a lot of ones. Well, apart from one dodge.
Alright, so that's the Black Orc tied up. Yeah, we can go here. Keep that one busy.
Yeah, that double skull annoyed me more because I wanted to blitz with that Black Orc that you've just tagged up.
Yeah, yeah, I can see how you might want to do that.
Considering he's got no star player points, I thought, you know, nice little beast man with no skills, punch him, cows him, get two, MVP, all good. But, you know, it didn't quite work that way.
Yeah, so if that were a thrower, you'd be glad he had pass at this point, because that's about the game plan. Oh,
there we go.
Oh, is that my last reroll? No, I've got two for two turns. Splendid. Splendid. There we go. There we go. It's all good. It's all good, man.
It's all Saul Goodman.
Saul Goodman, indeed. I really loved that moment when he showed where they show where the name came from. That was splendid.
I haven't actually. Is this in Better Call Saul?
Yeah,
like,
it is.
Yeah, I haven't watched Better Call Saul yet. It's on my like to watch list, but I've just not got around
good.
To it.
At some point, I started liking it better. It's a bit more down to earth. So, I mean, Breaking Bad is also brilliant in its absurdity at times, and Better Call Saul has a bit less of that over-the-top absurd.
To be honest, I enjoyed Breaking Bad, but I still think it was a little bit overrated. I didn't think it was made out to be like the greatest show ever, and it's sort of like, it's good, don't get me wrong, I had fun watching it, but I didn't think it was like mind-blowingly amazing.
Yeah, well, it was pretty consistently good also.
That's true.
I found. But yeah, so I could see why I had to get used to Better Call Saul for a bit. At first couple of episodes, I was like, am I gonna enjoy this at some point? And then I really did. Yeah.
And you really got, well, Saul was a great character in the show, so that was always fun.
Yeah.
Never mind.
Well, my turn 16 looks kind of doable there.
2-0, 3-0, who cares? It's a defeat.
Well, I get to skill up two beasts. That's kind of nice, right?
Yeah, I don't have to play you again, though, this season, so I don't care.
Yes, it's not your problem. It's,
no, it's not my problem.
It's Squiggy's problem.
Yeah.
Can I get three dice somewhere?
And to be honest, where you are in the league, it actually helped that you had a better team to beat everyone who you've got to play with to the rest, because it'll help me get into that top four, so... Go ahead. Beat them all.
Let's see. So that's... Yeah, no, I can't get three dice. Am I willing to risk a two die? He's on 25, though. He's getting close. I still need a 3+ pickup and a go.
Huh. Tell you what you shouldn't do. Roll double skulls. It's not good.
Yeah. Yeah. Good advice.
It is good. See, you give me good advice, I give you good advice. You know, it's give and take. Well,
don't roll skulls. Yes.
Don't roll skulls. Pro tip, as someone might say.
Yeah, sage advice, even.
Oh, sage advice. Oh, very well done.
Yes, it's a thing.
Yeah. I can't believe I didn't think of that. I do love a bit of a pun. Although, is sage advice a pun? I suppose it is.
Yeah,
but it's a saying,
it's a it's a reference. Yeah. Let's
There you go.
I don't actually have to worry about what you're doing. Yeah, I went with the block one rather than the claw one. Can I get someone in the end zone? No, that's actually a decision that I really enjoy in a situation like this. If I have guys who can stand in the end zone next to the ball.
To all put right, them so
there before I try to pick up,
so
just
if
in
they
case
happen
it bounces,
to, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't think I've actually had it work for me, but I've seen it work for people where that decision made the difference. Oh yeah,
well done,
got it. Actually, I could already tell that I got it.
Yeah, because it does that blue screen thing. That, yeah,
and if you still have a reroll, then it doesn't give you the blue screen if you fail because you could reroll. Mm. So the fact that it goes to the end of the game tells you. Yeah.
Which is mega anticlimactic as well. I hate that.
Yeah, just a bit, isn't it? But not as bad as the GG. Oh, wait, I can't GG because the game just kicked me from the chat.
No, yeah, that's true. But what is it? Just back to your thing about putting men in the end zone. I actually won a game once like that where the dude tried to pop the ball on his end zone, like to stop my man from scoring. And it ended up like, I think he chose both down.
Mm-hmm.
It was, and the ball basically scattered to a man of mine who was in the end zone who had it and caught it. It's like,
good. Nice.
Yeah. Well, at least I got good winnings out of that. That'll be good.
Oh, I didn't. I rolled a 2 and rerolled it into a 1.
Let me see my disaster team now. How badly? Oh, no, I need to validate, don't I? Yes.
Yeah. Yeah,
no, I don't validate this game. This game is illegal.
Yeah. No, it doesn't ask whether your players are invalids. It's that's different. Wow.
Thankfully, there was no like actual. I don't. Was someone? Did someone get niggled?
No, oh, someone got minus armored. Actually,
did they?
Yeah, that was one of mine though.
Oh, right. Okay. I was going to say my dirty player got a niggle, but I've got 3 players missing the next game. Ugh. Well, really, I've only got 2 because I'm going to fire off my niggled linemen. So.
Remember when I said, oh, I'm so going to get sure hands, now watch me roll agility and be annoyed?
What did you roll?
I didn't. It was strength.
Wow, that's pretty good as well.
Yeah, well, I prefer it on a warrior over a beastman, but, you know, I mean, I can accept that.
A little bit of extra strength is never a bad thing, is it? Yeah, so there you go.
Yeah, the other one got normal, so he can take sure hands probably.
Didn't have any skill ups, me. But I was happy with all the skills my men had. Didn't think they needed any more. They're all right for now.
Yeah. To be honest, your team is in a pretty decent squad, in a pretty decent shape, as long as you're not facing chaos.
Yeah, which isn't great. But as I said, I don't think there is another chaos team.
Yeah,
so.
There is, actually. I already played them. En passant, Crimson Fox.
Oh, right. For some reason, I keep thinking it's a Bretonian team because it's... En passant, that's why. But...
Peasant, yeah. No, this is in passing.
Okay. Is that what it means?
It's a chess rule, yeah.
I don't speak no French.
Well, I didn't know the chess rule. I understand enough French to see that this is in passing. And what it means is if a pawn moves 2 squares, which uh-huh. they can do,
yeah,
and you would be able to hit the square that he skipped, you can still hit the pawn in the square that he skipped.
Oh, really? Oh, I didn't
yes,
know that.
Apparently. Okay. No, me neither, but someone explained it to me on the stream when we were discussing names.
I almost feel like that would cause a fight if, like, I was actually playing someone properly, like, in a game.
You just made that up!
Yeah. No, I would never believe it. I'd be like, no, that's bullshit. That's not true. Like, I've never heard that. But there you go. All right,
apparently,
listen,
it's a thing.
A big congratulations. Well done. You deserve the win.
Thanks.
I hope you win all the rest of your games because that will help me in the league. So yeah. Keep on doing that. It was a pleasure to be on your stream as well. So
yeah, I really enjoyed having you over. This was good. Nice banter.
Hopefully we'll get to play again sometime. And yeah. And thanks stream for, you know, saying nice things about me. And those of you who didn't, you know, screw you. check out Berg787 on YouTube.
Yeah, and, do that.
All right.
As you can hear, Berg's a fun guy and he plays good bloodbowl.
Thank you very much. All right.
Later,
take care, guys. Good night. Bye.
Bye.
All right, YouTube. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this, remember to leave it a thumbs up at the bottom. And of course, if you'd like to see more videos, do check out the channel and hit subscribe on your top right.